We did have a question posted in the chat that I'm going to throw in now. This came in last month that I'd like to include now. And it concerns breakdown issues. The poster would like to hear the panel's thoughts, particularly around electric vehicles. So they had a driver recently who had to wait 4 hours to then be told they couldn't get the recovery couldn't get a flatbed until the next day. The driver obviously had to go back the next day because they wouldn't recover the car without them being present. I suppose really it has to be one for Duncan to kick off. Duncan.
Yeah, I'll see that one. Thank you. I think different breakdown roadside assistance companies do it different ways, okay? Not knowing the event there, I'm not sure whether it was one of ours or not, okay? But we have on our van, so every recovery van, so it's over 2,250 dedicated recovery vans can do all wheels up recovery. So two wheels out on the back of our cable recovery, so a compact recovery trailer. And our freewheeling hub on the two back wheels. So we can pick EVs up as equally as well as we can pick a 4x4 vehicle up on our vans. If it needs to be referenced to our trucks, we run the biggest truck fleet of recovery trucks in the UK, so we back it off. So there is no reason why EVs should not be treated any different to any other vehicle on the road from a physical recovery execution perspective. It's just that different companies do it different ways, and I'm not sure who was involved in that particular incident, but the operational methods is there to make sure it's a totally, totally consistent experience.
Mm-hmm. Chris, what's your experience been particular, I guess, around electric vehicles as well and recovery?
So our experience has been over the last couple of years, we've seen average response times go from just under an hour to now about 70 minutes. So there has been a slight increase in the delay before, on average, when somebody comes out. Just on our current stats, we're around 40% of our breakdowns are being seen within an hour. A further 40% are between the 1 hour and 2 hour mark, and 20% are over that 2 hour mark. We have had some issues, I think, but perspective needs to come in. We're operating a fleet of around about 1,800 vehicles, and we have had the odd one where people have been left to the following day and had to return to get a vehicle collected. We have had some issues where there have been electric vehicles and the breakdown has needed a further breakdown person to attend, but they are rare. They're few and far between, and when we look at the percentages we're getting, we don't believe we're getting a bad service. The user experience is very complimentary. So when the people are attending, we're getting really good feedback about what they're doing in terms of helping them. Also, what's good for me to see is that when we are making reporting breakdowns, they're being triaged and prioritised. We've not had a case of one of our delays where their safety has been compromised, so they've been stuck at the side of a motorway or in a dangerous position. So I think the service is generally working well. There is an acceptance on our part, and we've educated people about the delays. And some of the things that we've done is made sure people carry stuff that if they are delayed, so warm clothing, high vises, a bit of advice about making sure they get themselves to a safe place. But as I say, all in all, just a bit of a delay on what we were seeing a couple of years ago, but no real horrendous, horrible experiences from us.
Okay. Darren Russell posts in the chat about delays being experienced when the breakdown provider subcontracts the recovery to third-party agents, not necessarily on electric vehicle product. Del, what are your experiences?
I was going to say exactly the same thing. Our biggest issues come when it is contracted to a third-party supplier, and they're obviously not always in contact with the main agent who's subcontracted it, so it gets a bit tricky on those. I have to say, generally, it's a low volume, and it generally works very well. The other issue is when we get vehicles under warranty and the relationship between who the OEM might have as a recovery agent versus the lease co. And it's sometimes a bit of breakdown about who's recovering under different terms. But generally speaking, I think it works very well. And although vehicle recovery generally is one of the poorer scorers in customer services, it's pretty good, and it hasn't changed very much for EVs. But third-party stuff is a real issue.